The Human Rights Report highlighted that Kotido District was the most affected, reading in part, and we quote verbatim, a total of 1,676 deaths were reported in Kotido due to starvation and related illnesses arising from the long dry spell and famine in 2022. The Northern Division sub-county had 99 severely malnourished children, while Kapeta sub-county had 216 severely malnourished children on the verge of death due to starvation. Details from the commission indicate that most deaths were recorded in Rengen sub-county with 330 deaths, Maru sub-county 164, Longaroy 167, Kacheri TC 176, Kacheri 256, Kanea sub-county 143, and other deaths were in the rest of the district, apart from three sub-counties that never recorded deaths. 225 deaths due to starvation were recorded in Kabong district. Of these, 104 were males and 121 were female, with elderly above 60 years most affected.
Many people in Karamoja, they have lost animals, we have lost the lives and other property. Karamoja is really desperate. And then also neighbors from Acholi, from Lango, from Teso, from Bugisu, of course, they are being also disturbed. Then the issue of also Turkana in Kenya, who are now retaliating, attacking people within Karamoja sub-region.
While reacting to the findings in the report, many lawmakers welcomed the findings of the commission, attributing most deaths to the insecurity situation in Karamoja, and asked UPDF to put in place a strategic offensive against the armed rustlers. They also urged that in the fighting, the local innocent people should be protected.
The wood component, if people die because they have lacked food to eat, it should embarrass all of us. So we should support the initiatives there. I'm glad government is doing something on it by supporting crop farmers and all the farmers to do, and livestock farmers in different capacities.
But some MPs from Karamoja believe the number of deaths reported by the Uganda Human Rights Commission is understated. They say they witnessed more deaths in their constituencies than what was being reported.
Last year, there were about 2,000 people that had actually died, over 3,000 actually. When you look at it concurrently with the losses that we have had as a result of famine. So that is just understatement. Because we are saying we raised the red flag 3 years ago. And just imagine the situation has not been contained. And remember, those are only reported cases. There are cases of individuals that are dying, which have not been reported.
Lost many more people to insecurity alone. By March last year, our counting stopped when the number had reached 3,000. Then we lost people to hunger, starvation. The time when I raised it in Parliament as a matter of national importance, that time we had lost 1,400 people only to lack of food. So, and the deaths were just beginning. So, we've lost people. As you are aware, Karamoja is the only region in Uganda that has the highest number of people who die due to malaria. So the prevalence of malaria is high.
Now, Karamoja MPs have amplified their voices to demand that the government extends compensation in the form of ex gratia to families which lost their beloved ones. Faith Nakut, the Napak woman MP, wonders why the practice adopted by the president to extend 5 million shillings condolences to families that lose their people in tragedies is not applied to Karamoja.
I've seen government giving condolence mabugo to the massacre victims, condolence to the Chisoro victims of the flooding, of the landslides. We have seen government giving condolence, giving some contribution. We are waiting to see similar care for Karamoja, and we believe that it will happen.
Losses, just like you're making compensation for losses as a result of the atrocities of corn. The same applies to this, because this is banditry. So if everybody that loses things that are supposed to be guaranteed by the state should actually be compensated.
The government can have that statistic, because of course local people have their they have statistics, we have numbers. But if there was a way to be compensated, those people would be, their families would be compensated.
Report by Fred Kajubi for the news.